Welcome to Beano's Movie Land, ladies and gentlemen. There's the meatball. And basically, we got a comet to the left. Pretty much narrowed it down that it must be a comet that we got to the left there. And we know where we're at, and we know that Lovejoy is gone. And the reason we know that it's a comet, because we've seen a comet, Lovejoy, before move out. So basically, we pretty much know that that's a comet and not what we've seen from... Now, it's not 100% positive, but I would say 75% positive that that is a comet right there. Okay, where I've had my pointer at. And there's the meatball, there's Venus, and there's the sun and the supergiant's huge, juicy CME. And it's not juicy, that's flame, El Fuego. And wow, check that out. So we get a little bit better when we look at the movies because we don't get to where they take it out of the stalls. Now, there's names for that, and I just wrote it down the other day, too, because I ended up having a nice military scientific person get a hold of me on a sat phone so that it wouldn't be, well, I know Unky Sam ends up hearing it. Someone's Snoopy dog somewhere can smell it, so it doesn't really matter. But the idea, I got a call, and basically he was showing me some other stuff so that I have some wordings right. So I'll have some wordings correctly, and they want me to be the correct on it because they said that they've learned things from me. That the idea that not really learning agreeable theories of some scientists that they've always said and have been arguing a bunch of people, and then that idea it's not popular. So you could freeze that and check that electrical. They call them, if I'm trying to pull it out of my ass to remember what the name was, but they call it, you're not supposed to be able to see these on Earth, and you don't. You don't see the eddies that go to ground from our electrical static CMEs from the sun. Okay, but you can see electrical energy, and as you can see, when you see them come off, you know that we get from outer space. And what's wild is you see that there's other large stuff out there that's propagating before that, because as you see this, it plays fast enough that when you see the one from the supergiants in the sun come there like that, just before that, there will be like right there, there is light from way deep outer space from another angle. So you get an idea, because this meatball that you're looking at right there is the biggest damn thing you're ever going to see. That damn thing is huge. It's something under that huge object that is 740. And I think I've showed that we know it's like mass 48 or mass. That's a that thing is called M, and it's called a mass. And in the deep bowels of NASA, they call it the meatball. They ain't never gonna get away from it. So anyway, and a comet. So we got a lot of activity right here. Huge CME off the sun. That's a C, almost an M flare. And you have a comet to the, or actually this is the 12th. This actually, I screwed up on bringing up the information. This is possibly the M-class flare. So you know that the more than just the sun that gave us that M-class flare, because you can see how huge. And when you've seen Jupiter on here, and you'll see Jupiter on a SOHO shot again, or you can go back through SETI or SOHO, and you'll see what the size of Jupiter looks like. And Jupiter's the biggest thing in the Milky Way galaxy. Not, might be the biggest planet, that means a dead star, but it's not the biggest thing. So there you go, because the sun is in the supergiants, and the supergiants are in the Milky Way, and they're not just in the Milky Way. The supergiants are in vast amounts of space, and there you have a comet to the left. You can't miss that comet to the left. There's something there, and if you go to the footage of my video before this one today, I think I put on there, whatever. You just go to my videos. I put a few videos up today. Go look at all my videos that I put up today. Watch them all 15 minutes, because you miss stuff. What if at the last minute I put up this, that you get that electrical flash through from that huge CME on the 12th? So basically, I got lucky here finding something, because I just basically drew up the 12th instead of the, I think I was going to put the 18th in. So this is more dramatic than what I was going to show you. So this is wild. Okay, so this is played enough, and you guys can freeze this and everything like that. Go see what else we can fit in the video. Let me pull this up a little bit so you realize I'm not really trying to hide anything. There's planets up there too. So there you get a view of all that electrical energy. And then whammo. Kablammo. So, light. So, we've seen, the wild thing is there is CMEs. I'm going to stay here for a second, because you have to realize that anybody who has seen this light propagation, which we know is from a CME, we know that the sun's in the way back far of the supergiants, okay? And I'll see if I can pull up a graph on that, and so you're telling you, and you can realize by looking at this video that way up behind the sun, way the hell out, millions of miles, light years back there, that there is CMEs that are out there that have come by the sun when we've just been looking at the sun off of like and like I say, Earth is safe because we're hiding out, like, and we've hid out for billions of years, and they're constantly looking at something that gets anything close. Now, 130 some odd years from now, there is possibilities that there will be some objects, a meteor hit the Earth, but that's like 130 years on out. So, anyhow, the race for space is on Major League. Everybody's getting their butt up there. So this is huge footage here that basically shows you that the idea that when we've seen this light propagation before by just looking at the sun and going like, well, what the hell is all that? Because it's from way the hell out, and it dies off kind of like what these would be dying off way out into space, because you can see how they're going to die out, and that's what we end up with sometimes up by the sun with all those light propagations. There's huge CMEs from suns way, 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 way out behind the sun. So the sun is not the only sun. It's our sun. Let's hope it sticks around for a while. And no matter what, basically that comet being gone there, I mean, from the news media and science letting us know about it, because that's a comet. You can't say that that's not a comet right there. Okay, that looks like a damn comet. And it'll be there on the 18th. I'll bring up the 18th footage. It'll still be there. I need to go search something before the 18th, and it's not Lovejoy. So I went back a few more days, and I guess basically I apologize for not going to Sechi, folks, because basically we would have caught this comet earlier. But then again, did it come out from behind the meatball? And that's what I am basically, I think that's very factual, that it probably did come out from behind the vast distance of the meatball there, as you see Venus there, and then you got the head of the comet. You can actually see the front end of this thing, okay? That's the front end of that comet. So there's a comet. Either that. And then if it is a comet, is it a particle that has came off of one of the mass CMEs of the sun and we never noticed it, and it's flying through space? That is a possibility. As you can see, it's somewhat of a direction of that CME, that massive CME that comes off the sun. Or is it just, and remember, the sun is in there with the supergiants, so the idea that, the factual, that the idea that could be some particles from smack smack with the sun in the supergiants or other giant stars in the supergiants main sequence or anywhere in space. So there's a comet. It's absolutely a comet going through space out there that we haven't been let known about. And the idea that it's somewhat below Earth in our vicinity, because we know that we are somewhere level with Venus and Mercury and above high somewhere here in a V action back towards, because this is ahead. So Earth is over here somewhere, and that is a comet below us, hopefully. It doesn't matter. So it's interesting to know where Earth is on this shot. Okay, so where is stereo today, A and V? So we're looking from B, and it's pretty much relatively the same position somewhat of all those shots we just showed you. So remember, when you're looking at the beacon, we'll go back to beacon, and we'll look at Venus and Mercury, and you'll see it from A and B. So the idea, you'd be seeing Mercury from A to the right, and from B, you'd be seeing Venus to your right. Okay, and from A, you're going to be seeing Mercury to your left, I suppose. So anyway, Earth's over here. That's our map. And the earlier videos today, I show this movement of this. There's a video of this here object there below the sun moving around. We know it's not anything we just seen on the map. So I guess that would have been Mercury on ahead. And basically behind is this shot. So something above and below, because it sure looks like you're more than likely either that or there's something to do with. And now you see that there's been a fresher shot of two blanking outs of this too. So and I'm not playing with you on this, folks. Basically, this is how this plays. So it plays around a lot, and you can go ahead and take your pictures of what, but it sure seems like that there's something moving around. That's a huge CME. So I got a feeling there's something huge that's flying along that they don't really want you to see. Now that's looking back, because that's the sun and the supergiants back here to the left, even though it's behind shot. Okay. Sometimes they move the scope or the satellite's opticals around or it, because you know from seeing this, the sun and the supergiants are back here to the left. And that, I believe, should possibly be that magnetism line there is Venus. I.e., that's why Venus is close to the camera on, I believe. Well, anyway, we know it's close to Earth right now, so it looks larger, and it's very bright because it's getting CME action like crazy, and then we don't have a moon out at night, and you're seeing not a real dark evening without a full moon because of the sun and the supergiants. So that's your latest footage, and you can freeze in there somewhere and get what you want to get. So anyway, we do believe that probably should be Venus. I.e., that should have been Venus, you'd figure. Because that's the sun to the left over here. This is the sun, and then Venus is on that magnetism line somewhere on the right. Ooh, there you go. There, I was able to lucky to do some more than likely. And then, so there's something else out there hanging out with Venus. Okay? There's some other planet out there by Venus. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Because you know that the sun and the supergiants are here, and they turned it around, and this is Venus somewhere. I would think that this is Venus, or this is Venus, and there's another planet out by Venus, and also another planet right here in front of the sun. So you got 1, 2, 3 in front of the sun, because you can't miss it when we play the video. You know that that's the sun. The sun and the supergiants, or something's really hella bright down here. Okay? So play back to where I froze it. And there you go. Footage from space from stereo behind H12. H-high 2. Sorry, folks. Hi to Beano's Human. Anyways, lucky to freeze it again anyway. So you know that they can move the optics. We have always kind of known that. So anyway, or turn the satellite around. Doesn't really matter. So you know that from behind, that's what you're getting for a shot, because that was the sun playing there to the left. And there's three planets right there. So there's something hanging out, even if it was Mercury somewhere in that shot, if it possibly got over, that the idea that there was some other planet here between the sun and Earth, Venus, and Mercury, okay? 100,000% positive, because your eyes do not lie to you. You got a planet here, planet there. Magnetism lines. You can't miss them. Bang, bang, bang. So even if this ends up being Venus, there's two other planets here. So then an Earth in this shot. So then what the hell is hanging out between Venus and us and Earth? You see? So no matter what, there's stuff out there that you have to look at the photos and figure it out for yourself, and then you somewhat know that there's stuff there they're not telling us. And I'll see what I got for a date for here. So what do I got? I was showing Venus. Yeah, it's current. This is what I pulled up Venus. So Jupiter. Okay. So we're starting to, and basically, so that's a good idea that, remember, Jupiter is not that damn big, and realize how huge, okay? They're not showing you on the map that Jupiter can be seen on that SOHO shot, but it can. And so, massively, I got to realize that we have another. So that is, that's the sun, and then that's the moon. Oh, duh, okay. So what I'm trying to say is, real fast, is the idea that they're not showing us Jupiter on the map. So this should scare the hell out of you how big the meatball is. But hopefully it is hella far out. And it is. It's hella far out from Earth, the meatball. Okay? Because no matter what, there's your map. Okay? There's where it is today. And there's our newest video from the 18th. Huge CME. And there's your meatball. You can't miss your meatball. And the CME shows it in space. You can't hide it. So it's right there, the meatball. You can't miss it. Play this video. And play it and play it, and you've seen all the photos that have caught it with too. The meatball is there, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, there's massive distance in space that we're getting on here, and there's that comet too. And the head we've seen on the earlier shots where I went back on that date that you see, I'm not even going to miscomment myself, because you can back the video up and watch the date where we've seen the head on this comet that's coming through. And that's a damn large comet when you think about it, ladies and gentlemen. It's a huge comet that they're not telling us about, because realize the size of Venus and the size of Jupiter, and remember there's Venus, and then the idea that we have the magnetic shot that you can back up the video and go to the beacon shot that I froze the video on, okay? So there is a massive comet below Venus and way out, leaving the meatball, the sun and the supergiants and Venus and us and Earth behind and going off into space. So